It's civilization-ending poison. But it's everywhere. How widespread is it? Well, we can't really be sure until we finally get cameras in the classroom, as we put them on the chests of police officers, until we finally get a civilian review board in every town in America to oversee the people teaching your children, forming their minds. And let's hope we get both of those very soon. But until we do, we can't know exactly how widespread this is. But there are indications.
Wait, was Tucker Carlson just arguing for policing our thoughts? That's incredibly authoritarian, but it's not the first time he's gone that far.
Your response when you see children wearing masks as they play should be no different from your response to seeing someone beat a kid in Walmart. Call the police immediately. Contact Child Protective Services. Keep calling until someone arrives.
There was a time when calling cops on parents or policing our thoughts were examples of a dystopian future. But that was Fox News' Tucker Carlson doing exactly that in an over-the-top scary segment on critical race theory. Hi, I'm Colby Hall. Thank you for joining.
In the wake of protests of the murder of George Floyd, Republican politicians have been hyping critical race theory as a threat to the impressionable minds of America's children.
Critical race theory says every white person is a racist. Critical race theory says America is fundamentally racist and irredeemably racist.
That was CNN's Ellie Reeve, who interviewed parents about critical race theory, many of whom, shockingly, had no clue what they were talking about.
Critical race theory is the idea that's taught to our nation's youth that the way that you're born contributes to the amount of success that you can achieve.
To paint the country as a inherently racist country from its founding, I think is dangerous.
The three-fifths compromise is written into the Constitution in which slaves are counted as three-fifths of a person.
Of course, and that was applied at an earlier time. That is not the case now, obviously.
Well, you just mentioned the founding of the country, so.
Well, yeah, it wasn't perfectly written in the Constitution.
When did you first hear about critical race theory?
Sometime around last year.
Where'd you see it?
I'm on Fox News.
Oh, Fox News, right. The wildly influential conservative media outlet most responsible for critical race theory misinformation.
The scourge of critical race theory is most acutely felt in our schools. Parents all over the country now see the evils being perpetrated by activist school boards and teachers.
How do you negotiate and reconcile with those that teach critical race theory in school, abolish capitalism and individualism?
This is the pathology that occurs when we're teaching critical race theory into our institutions, because critical race theory, again, basically teaches that our institutions are racist.
Look, critical race theory is pretty high-minded stuff, like postgraduate level. So K-12 kids aren't really facing this. But also, discrimination based on race didn't magically end in the 60s with the Civil Rights Act. And those who don't learn about history, well, they're bound to repeat it. Thank you for watching.